Get ready for the dictation. Dictation will start in 5 seconds. Start. Mr. Deputy Chairman, the railways are a premier public undertaking, and as such, it is expected that they should be run as a model commercial department. For a number of years, successive public accounts committees have drawn attention to over-budgeting, lack of control over budgeting, the delay in quick disposal of disciplinary cases, delays in recovery of dues, drawing up contracts and their execution, resulting in an avoidable expenditure. To take up the first over-budgeting, I would submit that in 16 grants, there was over-budgeting. There were supplementary grants and appropriation obtained in a number of cases, which proved to be excessive. Savings also occurred in a number of cases due to delay in finalization of plans. Successive public accounts committees have made serious complaints in regard to the delay in disposal of disciplinary cases. Time and again, the Railway Board has been approaching the Public Accounts Committee with a request to close past cases, and the committee had no option but to accede to this request. If this department is to be run as a model commercial department and set an example to both public and private undertakings, such things should not be allowed to occur. A number of cases had to be closed because the officers concerned had retired and no action could be taken against them. I would here like to submit a typical case. There was an officer against whom the special police establishment had made a serious allegation in 1981. This officer was finally removed from service in 1989, that is after 8 years. He was in the meantime promoted and retained in a higher post. Such delays have also enabled delinquent officers in a number of cases to escape due punishment because of retirement from service in the meantime. This indeed is a very unsatisfactory state of affairs, and if we have to serve as a model and in a business-like manner, then we have to see that the exchequer is not put to such losses by decisions being delayed for 8 years and allowing the officer concerned to be promoted from one post to another in the meantime. There is delay in the awarding of contracts resulting in loss to the exchequer. I would invite your attention to a particular case where an order was placed for the manufacture of a composite coach full stop.